Yeah. We at war. We at war with terrorism, racism, but most of all, we at war with ourselves. God, show me the way because the devil's trying to break me down.
How's it going, guys? This is episode 3 of Masamune's Redemption. I got Mr. Reckless here. Go ahead and say hey.
What's up, everybody?
Today, we're going to be kind of putting together something that will allow us to compare the old Naruto and the new Naruto. And we're a couple of original players. And we've been in a few tournaments. Reckless was the last champion at our school, and then before that it was me. So we have a lot to compare with the fight system and the mechanics regarding the old Ultimate Ninja and the new Ultimate Ninja Storm. All right, so the first topic we want to talk about is going to be balance. Man, what can we say about balance, really?
Well, coming from our playing the old Naruto, I would say that in order to be good with your character, you know, you would have to actually learn a lot about your character. What moves works best for you in what situation. And I just don't see that in the new Naruto. Like, I just think everybody tries to find that one character where they can just spam their way through a victory, or, you know.
I completely agree. Because a lot of people will say, okay, well, this character has this advantage over every character in general. So,
right.
You know, I'm going to continue to use this method because it has the highest rate of a possibility of giving me the V, you know, giving me the victory.
Right.
And you don't see in the new Naruto quite as much, okay, I'm going to take this character, try to master him, find out what combos work best. It's more just like a couple things with each character.
Right. And I think that's kind of the developer's fault too, but that's like, you know, a different topic that we're going to get into as far as like the combinations and, you know, other things that, you know, that help in certain situations or whatever. Like,
oh yeah,
I don't know, we don't have a lot to go with compared to the older Naruto. The older Naruto, there was so much. We were learning new moves like every day.
Oh my god,
as
yes,
as much as we played that game,
man,
we were learning new moves
every day. Alright, so next topic is combinations, and we were just talking about that one. You know, kind of just left off. We're just going to pick up from the last topic. Within combinations, that was a real good point, because I felt like I was able to, you know, start combinations in the air, you know, helping get the opponent in the air, especially if they're running low on chakra. Mm-hmm. You know, there were combinations where I had to, you know, for example, we had an opponent who was using Shikamaru, Devon Shed.
One of the greats.
One of the greats, yes. Yes, definitely. You know, and the old Ultimate Ninja Shippuden, Shikamaru would make a bomb. You know, for all you who didn't know, you go back and watch some videos on YouTube. If you threw a kunai at it, you know, a whole spray of kunais would come out. I mean, you had to find a combination that was best to get that started before he would start it on you.
Oh, and it took us how long before we found, like, a theory to get around that?
Oh my god, yes.
And see, that's the thing, like, Shikamaru now in the new one, he's not used a lot. He's rarely used. But our friend Devon, he took Shikamaru to a level that no one can probably take Shikamaru to that level. I'm sorry. He took Shikamaru to like a god status.
Yes.
It's ridiculous.
Yes. Now, strategical. found out every aspect of that Shikamaru.
Yeah.
From laying down little pop-up bombs to...
Yeah.
Man.
And it's like, he used Shikamaru in the way that he would, like, I don't know, he would work in the anime. Like, he used him in the way that he would, like, be used in the anime. Like,
yeah.
Like, in a smart way. He wasn't aggressive, but at the same time, he didn't sit back the whole time. He knew when to be aggressive.
Yes.
And he knew when to sit back and, you know, play at his advantage.
Exactly. So. Master of substitution, you know. So if he did actually get out there and do some taijutsu, which he would only do in his awakening form, you know he would be able to substitute.
Yeah. And another thing, like, I want to talk about in combination is in the new one, starting up a combination and not being able to end it.
Oh, like, my God. Yes.
At will.
Yes.
Like, once you're in a combination, you have to finish your combination. Even if the person substitute behind you, that just leaves you open to get a special up your ass. To be real.
All right, so this topic, we're coming right off the other topic, right into support characters. What can we say about support characters? There's a lot we can say about support characters, man, especially coming from being two original Naruto fighters in the Ultimate Ninja series. I think Ultimate Ninja has been fine all the way up until the point where they started throwing in those damn support characters.
Alright, me, I think that support characters would be cool. Like I was telling you, it would be cool if you make it an item. Like, where you can use it twice, or maybe three times, and that's it.
Yes.
You can't use it again.
Yes.
Like, it should be a one-on-one battle. Your skills versus my skills. Not the computer skills versus my skills. Like, that's retarded. Like, that's stupid.
Yes.
I don't like it at all.
Yeah, two things for me. One, yeah, that would be a great idea, because then it would make you think more on saying, all right, look, I only got, you know, I got two support characters, but I can only use them both once. When am I going to break them out, you know?
Right.
Do I need to recover chakra? Let me pull one out so I can recover some chakra. Or, you know, this is a good chance I can get this guy off guard, you know what I'm saying? That is perfect. Okay, that's one for me. Number two, make it an option. You know, if you're going to do online ranking, oh my God, make it an option, for God's sake. They did well on the non-ranking by giving you the option to say, okay, I'm going to do single matches, one versus one, or I'm going to do, you know, team matches, you know. I want to fight people with teams. You know, give them the option on ranking, please, because that shows off a little bit more skill. You know, that shows off a lot more skill. You know, that alone made the game a little bit more enjoyable. Go back and watch, you know, one versus one matches I have, besides me and you. We have a training match on my YouTube.
Yeah.
Like a training montage of just me and you fighting each other one versus one. But, you know, if you go back and watch the fight against Orochimaru when he was using Kisame, you know, that was an epic fight, because you really, it takes away everything else. You can only see the player's skill.
Yeah, you know, they challenge you as well. Like, there's no help, there's nobody to get you out of anything.
No, you have to get yourself out of it.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Man, the support characters are used way too much in everything.
Oh my God.
And throwing kunais and take away specials and blocking for you and too much.
Alright, so the next segment that we're gonna talk about is the specials, and we're gonna title it specials plus cancellations. But before we go into that, one more thing we had to touch base on. What was that again?
Oh yeah, that in the old Naruto, like, we had the option to use support characters, but we never used them. And in our tournaments, if you were using, like, if you use a support character, then you were banned. You were basically kicked out.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
We, like, we looked at support characters as, like, you know, as, like,
a cheating item.
Yeah, like a handicap or something.
Yeah, it was a handicap, basically.
Yeah.
Basically, yeah, that's a real good point. And the fact that we were skilled enough not to use not one support character during the tournament, during an intense, I'm talking about substitute out of everything every 5 seconds, talking about hopping over each other.
That's another thing that the new Naruto doesn't have. Remember when we, in the tournament, when I did the Rasengan,
mm-hmm.
and you did was it the trigram?
Oh, the Kaiten. I would do the spin.
Do
the Kaiten.
And they would collide together, and you have the little smash or whatever.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Oh my God, the clash.
Those are epic moments, right?
Jutsu
there.
Clash was one of the coolest things, you know, yeah. And it was one of the most epic moments too. Yeah.